The Australian Atomic Energy Commission has begun work on the Leucocytes Research Establishment with its 10,000 kilowatt nuclear reactor. Drilling operations to determine rock foundations in the building area are almost finished. In bushland, 25 miles south of Sydney, the laboratories and the reactor become part of a program for harnessing atomic energy. No country on its own can experiment with all the ways of producing atomic power. Many countries are cooperating in research, and Australia will now be able to make its contribution. HIFAR, the name stands for High Flux Australian Reactor, is a research reactor and will not produce power. But from its associated laboratories will come experiments to determine the scope of the power-producing reactors of the future. The large U-shaped building will house the chemistry and chemical engineering laboratories where experiments will be made with radioactive materials. A 120 feet high stack with its associated air filters will form part of the extensive ventilating system of the laboratory. The spectacular feature of the establishment will be the reactor itself. The bulk of the construction work has been done on the site by Australian workmen, but the reactor core was brought from England. Atomic energy, perhaps the world's most vital subject today. With the arrival of the reactor core, Australia has joined the search for new knowledge. A 64-ton steel tank, which is 13 feet high and 11 feet in diameter, houses the core of the reactor, which, when complete, will weigh 1,400 tons. Australians are beginning to take an interest in atomic energy. What will go on inside this reactor? The reactor core is a tank. Its fuel elements are the uranium with a control arm which can be raised or lowered to control the neutrons when they're at work during the chain reaction. From storage tanks below comes the heavy water which slows down the neutrons to a speed most suitable for the job of splitting uranium atoms. A graphite shield around the tank reflects the neutrons. Further shielding prevents escape of neutrons and radioactivity. The outer casing is a heavy concrete shell. Shielding above protects personnel. Portholes allow materials or fuel samples to be put into the reactor. The chain reaction begins, and neutrons are fired like an atomic bullet into the core of a uranium atom. This splits into two simpler atoms, and this releases more neutrons, which in turn split more atoms. And so, power builds up. Samples of materials are introduced through the portholes to test their resistance to radioactivity or to make radioactive isotopes. On the site, work has almost ended. The reactor core is in position, and around it has been placed the graphite reflector and the steel and concrete shielding. The whole reactor is enclosed in an airtight steel containment shell, 70 feet high, 70 feet wide. The building job is done. Now the vital tools of the reactor core are put into position. The stainless steel cadmium-filled control arms absorb neutrons, thus keeping the nuclear chain reaction within bounds and enabling it to be shut down completely. elements are made of plates of highly enriched uranium-aluminium alloy and are arranged so that the heavy water coolant may circulate freely to carry away the heat formed by the nuclear reaction. First, heavy water is pumped from storage tanks into the core of the reactor. To start off the reaction, a radium-beryllium source to provide neutrons is put into the core. The reactor is operated from the control room inside the shell. Instruments show exactly what's happening at each moment, and adjustments can be made immediately. It's the day of the opening, and the Prime Minister, Mr. R.G. Menzies, is shown through the reactor. It's a complex subject. Heavy water comes through the core of the reactor to cool it and take away heat produced by the reaction. The heavy water itself is then cooled by ordinary water in a heat exchanger. As the Lucas Heights reactor is for research and is not designed to produce electrical power, the water has to pass through cooling towers before going back into the heat exchanger. A final check of the control room and then the official opening ceremony has begun.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Right Honourable the Prime Minister.
This, you know, is a very historic occasion for Australia. Indeed, it's an historic occasion in the world, because we're opening an establishment that is related to something so new in the world that it's not so many years ago that nobody, non-scientific at any rate, had thought of it.
The Prime Minister went on to say, we have power from coal, power from water, and in the future, Australia will have power from atomic energy.
I declare the establishment open.
If you have fears, prepare to shed them now, because my next task is to press the white button, to press it very hard, to hope that the other button will go red. And if all that happens, no doubt somebody will start something somewhere, just like a cabinet meeting.
I know that's right, they told me.
Administrative buildings, laboratories, the reactor itself now stand where not long ago banchers and blue gums struggled for survival in the stony soil. Within a short time of its opening, the Lucas Heights reactor was giving new knowledge, new techniques to Australian science and industry. It looks to the future and brings the future with its promise of energy unlimited closer to today.